If you like American history, please subscribe to our channel and ring that bell so you can be notified when we put up a new video. When most people think of the first video game, they think of Pong, the ping-pong arcade game released by Atari in August 1972. Nolan Bushnell, Pong's inventor, referred to himself as father of video games. However, he was wrong. He was not the father of video games, and Pong was not the first. So, what was the first home video game? And who fathered this amazing industry that generates more money than the movie and music industry combined? The answers are next on Mark in History. This is the historical marker for Ralph Baer, known as the father of video games. Right next to the marker is his life-size bronze statue resting on a park bench and holding the first video game console. His marker and statue are located here in Manchester, New Hampshire, a few hundred feet south of the Notre Dame Bridge. Ralph held more than 150 U.S. and foreign patents and had a profound influence on electronic games, military simulators, and medical devices. He also had a lot to do with a little game you might have heard of, the game Simon. Ralph Baer licensed the very first home video game to Magnavox.
This is Odyssey, the new electronic game simulator,
who rebranded it as the first interactive video game system, the Magnavox Odyssey, and released it in 1972. Months before the Pong arcade game was introduced. Now, the rest of the story. It all started on a summer day in 1966. Ralph Baer is waiting to meet a colleague at the New York City Port Authority bus terminal. He uses his free time scribbling notes on a small pad. It was a defining moment in gaming history. The subject was using ordinary home TV sets for the purpose of playing games.
What do we do with a television set except watch Channel 4, shut it off when there's nothing decent on? Here's this expensive display that's in everybody's home. It costs very little because it's made by the millions, so why not do something else with it? So I said, well, let's play games. That's how it started. I get back to the office and I wrote a description which lays it all out, and that's how it started.
His conceptual ideas included action games, board games, sports games, card games, shooting games, and chase games. And the target audience were owners of over 52 million TV sets in American homes. The date was September 1st, 1966, the genesis of a brand new industry. Next year, Ralph convinced his employer, Sanders Associates, a huge defense contractor in New Hampshire, to fund a small R&D team and begin development. His first test device was simply called TV Game Number 1. Users could play ping pong with a dot on the screen. Sanders first applied for U.S. patents in mid-1967. Ralph called it gaming because it was a term regularly used in the military and gave the project the appearance of being within the company's scope of interest as a military contractor. He understood that the games had to be fun or investors and consumers would not be interested. 1 year later, Ralph Baer and his team created the seventh version of their TV game unit. It became known as the Brown Box because they covered the aluminum chassis with brown, self-adhesive wood grain vinyl to make it look a little more attractive. Games included ping pong, handball, hockey, volleyball, target shooting, and golf putting. Cards illustrated which switches to select in order to play a certain game. In 1971, Magnavox licensed the technology from Sanders and in the summer of 1972 released its Magnavox Odyssey home video game system.
Magnavox presents Odyssey, the electronic game of the future. Odyssey easily attaches to any brand TV, black and white or color, to create a closed-circuit electronic playground. Odyssey gives you all the exciting action of hockey and 11 other challenging play and learning games for the entire family. Odyssey, a new dimension for your television. Now at your Magnavox dealer. He's listed in the yellow pages.
Now comes the controversy and the lawsuits. Some say that Pong was the first video game because it was so popular when it first came out. The date was August 1972 at Andy Capp's Tavern in Sunnyvale, California. However, months earlier, Magnavox had already released its Odyssey home video game console, and on March 22, 1971, a full year before Pong appeared in arcades, Bear and his company Sanders had filed for the first video game patent, which was later approved. Nolan Bushnell would have a difficult time proving paternity. Here is his signature on the visitor sign-up sheet to play Odyssey's ping-pong game during an open house on May 24, 1972. Keep in mind, this was months before Pong, the arcade game, would magically appear in bars. It was years later that Bushnell finally admitted to the fact that the concept for Pong game was inspired by playing Magnavox's Odyssey. In April 1974, Magnavox filed a patent infringement suit against Atari. Although Magnavox had no legal claim to the game of table tennis itself, Magnavox noted that Bear's broad-range patent covered any technology that used electric circuits to control dots on a standard television screen. During trial, Judge John Grady asked to see the inside of a Pong arcade game. Inside was a modified black-and-white Admiral TV set turned into a television monitor. The trial ended with Judge Grady's decision in favor of Magnavox. Atari settled for $1.5 million and became the first licensee of the technology from Magnavox in order to continue to market Pong and other video games that followed. Meanwhile, sales of Magnavox Odyssey spiked because of the success of Pong. Consumers bought the Odyssey game console so they could play their favorite arcade game at home. With approximately 350,000 units sold, Magnavox Odyssey was not considered a commercial success. However, Magnavox would generate almost three times the revenue of Odyssey sales by filing lawsuits against game companies infringing on Bear's patent. All told, Magnavox won over $100 million from lawsuits alone.
If you're an electronics type,
Ralph Bear never did stop inventing. Ralph Bear's most famous and successful game had to be Simon, the handheld single-chip microprocessor game licensed to Milton Bradley in 1978. In an example of irony, Simon was inspired by Atari's arcade game called Touch Me. 40 years later, Simon is still being played by millions. In 2004, Ralph Bear is awarded the National Medal of Technology by President George W. Bush. Bear continued to invent electronic games and toys until his passing on December 7, 2014, at the age of 92. Today, you can visit Ralph Bear's basement workshop on display at the Smithsonian Institute in Washington, D.C. And it all started with Bear's bus stop brainstorm on a summer day in 1966. If history can be taught with stories, it can never be forgotten. Please like our video, subscribe to our channel, and ring the bell to stay informed on the latest videos. And don't forget to leave your comments below and tell us what you like about this video.